You see, the penalty, as you may know, is confiscation and imprisonment."
The captain of the Mary Thomas shrugged his shoulders in seeming indifference and turned away. Although they may restrain all outward show, strong men under unmerited misfortune are sometimes very close to tears. Just then the vision of his little California home and of the wife and two yellow-haired boys was strong upon him, and there was a strange choking sensation in his throat which made him afraid that if he attempted to speak he would sob instead. And also there was upon him the duty he owed his men, no weakness before them, for he must be a tower of strength to sustain them in misfortune. He had already explained to the second lieutenant, and he knew the hopelessness of the situation. As the sea lawyer had said, the evidence was all against them. So he turned aft and fell to pacing up and down the poop of the vessel over which he was no longer commander. The Russian officer now took temporary charge. He ordered more of his men aboard, and had all the canvas clewed up and furled snugly away. While this was being done, the boat plied back and forth between the two vessels, passing a heavy hawser which was made fast to the great towing bits on the schooner's forecastle head. During all this work, the sealers stood about in sullen groups. It was madness to think of resisting, with the guns of a man-of-war not a biscuit toss away. But they refused to lend a hand, preferring instead to maintain a gloomy silence. Having accomplished his task, the lieutenant ordered all but four of his men back into the boat. Then the midshipman, a lad of 16, looking strangely mature and dignified in his uniform and sword, came aboard to take command of the captured sealer. Just as the lieutenant prepared to depart, his eyes chanced to alight upon Bub. Without a word of warning, he seized him by the arm and dropped him over the rail into the waiting boat, and then, with a parting wave of his hand, he followed him.